Mr. Speaker, as we speak today, the people of Puerto Rico continue to suffer. Currently, 200,000 families and businesses, 16% of the island, remains without power. That is not 6 days after the hurricane or 6 weeks. We're talking about 6 months. For those still without power in Puerto Rico, they are now living through the longest blackout in modern history. And while parts of the island are recovering, it is the rural, far-flung portions of the island that continue to suffer the most and where aid has been slowest to reach. For example, if you go to my hometown of Yabucoa, where Maria made landfall, it looks like the hurricane struck yesterday. Two-thirds of the residents living there are without electricity. For decades, Yabucoa's baseball stadium stood as an important symbol of that town's community. The people there love baseball, and the stadium was a community anchor, a symbol of the town and its people. Those who live in Yabucoa are proud of their baseball diamond. At this town, fielded Puerto Rico's team in the 2017 Junior League World Series. Today, the baseball stadium sits empty, now a symbol of how the people of Yabucoa struggle daily to survive. Meanwhile, basic services are hard to come by, with hospitals relying on generators to provide life-saving treatment. Other rural parts of Puerto Rico continue to suffer immensely. 30 miles east of Yabucoa's coast sits the island of Vieques. As an island off an island, Vieques also has been neglected, waiting for the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers to restore power. Just a few weeks ago, I was there and saw this on the road. Power poles dangling from electric wires, just waiting to snap. Can you imagine seeing that in the mainland United States? Again, this is not a week or two after the hurricane. It is close to 6 months later. Meanwhile, the island's connection to the main power grid has been cut off. And some workers think it will take years to fully restore the undersea cables. Those are just two towns in a commonwealth of 3.3 million American citizens. But all across Puerto Rico, there are rural areas that have been hit hard and that are still suffering today. We cannot afford to forget what has happened there. These are fellow American citizens. For 120 years, they have fought, shed blood, and died in our wars, defending our freedoms. Now they need our help to recover from a humanitarian crisis. I implore my colleagues, we must not forget Puerto Rico. We must allocate additional aid and help. We must rebuild Puerto Rico stronger and better than ever before. Until we do, we will be failing the people of Puerto Rico. We will be failing our fellow Americans. I yield back.